It's time for Countdown to Kickoff with Sonny Jurgensen and Sam Hupp.
Thank you. Thank you, and thank you for joining us on Countdown to Kickoff. And believe me that your applause was much better than you did in rehearsal.
I want to tell you, it seems like the more the Redskins win, the louder our audience applause. That's great. That's wonderful.
And you see all those W's at Warner Corporation's here with us again. W's on those red hats there. That's good.
Getting to be a habit.
Redskins win today. They clinched the NFC East for the first time since 1987.
They're absolutely amazing, aren't they? Had to be 12-0 if they win today against Dallas.
Yeah, you think about 12-0 records or just in the 12th game of the season. There are three other teams that can also clinch their divisions today. On those red hats there, that's good.
Getting to be a habit.
Redskins win today. They clinch the NFC East for the first time since 1987.
They're absolutely amazing, aren't they? Had to be 12-0 if they win today against Dallas.
Yeah, you think about 12-0 records or just in the 12th game of the season, there are three other teams that can also clinch their divisions today.
Yep.
And the Saints, besides Washington, the Saints in the AFC, Buffalo at 10-1. But Buffalo needs the Jets to lose in order, it's a little mathematical thing. Everybody has to win, but they have to lose. And then Houston can also clinch their Central Division.
Well, they're really playing for home field advantage over there. Buffalo wants to get Houston in Buffalo. They don't want to play in Houston,
right,
indoors. They want to get them up there where it's cold. The wind's blowing, the snow's blowing. It's miserable.
You know, you were talking about how well the Redskins are playing, Sam, and... they are leading the National Football League in seven categories. Look at this. In points scored, points differential, touchdowns, they're tied with that. Third down conversions, it's unbelievable.
How about interceptions?
Interceptions, too. There's really one that we don't have on our stats there, and that is would have to be in sacks ratio. The Redskins have 35 sacks, right, and they've only given up four. Plus 31 there, that's a big ratio.
But, you know, I was reading in the paper, USA Today and things, about the offensive line. Everybody that has the big offensive line and protect the quarterback, they are now winning. What a change, right? These guys are also able to hold. They're big and they're tough and they hold and they do takedowns. And so they don't get the quarterback sacked. They don't even have a lot of holding penalties anymore. The poor defensive guy, the defensive ends, the defensive tackles, you don't even hear about him anymore.
Well, the Redskins have 35 sacks.
Yeah.
How do they get around those offensive lines?
Well, you know, you got Stokes, they're quick. You got Stokes and Charles Mann and Tim Johnson. Harry,
you know, the team they're playing today, the Dallas Cowboys, they've split with the Redskins the last 3 years. And out at Redskins Park this week, I talked with Joe Gibbs, and I asked him, why the Dallas Cowboys seem to play so well against the Redskins?
I don't know. I think that certain teams seem to have a good feeling about playing other teams. It's in our division for sure.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like there's trade-offs. You know, we don't do well against the Giants. Philly doesn't do well, right, against the Giants. Don't do well against Philly, and it's kind of those kind of things. And I think with us, we've had a struggle with Dallas, and I think it's because, hey, they do seem to play well against us. They have a confidence. They beat us here at RFK. I know they're coming in here. They're not worried about this, being in front of our crowd. I'm just hoping that, hey, a lot of other things have been special about this year. I'm hoping that maybe this approach for us in playing this game will be special. We'll just have to see.
How about that? Boy, Joe Gibbs, he's getting his hat more down over his face, more thing. He's getting the collar up. I wonder what he concentrated on this week. He had nothing to focus on because this team is going so well. Last week, well, we had two block punts. Week before that,
spirited practices all week. And we're going to have a good show for you. We've got a preview of the Dallas Cowboys, a team that's desperate to win because to keep their playoff hopes alive. Also, we'll be talking with Rennie Simmons, offensive line and tight end coach of the Redskins. And look at some of last week's big hits around the NFL.
You know, and each week we have the best guy giving us a little bit of the insight about the Redskins, and that's James Brown. We'll get to James Brown.
All right, Sam, thank you very much. Today we're going to take a look at a group of guys I know you have an awful lot of respect for. Washington's offensive line, a group that certainly has played a large role in Washington's unbelievable success this season. We'll profile them next.
Countdown to Kickoff. Brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. See them for Toyota Value, the best deal going. CNP Telephone, we're more than just talk. Warner, we do it right the first time. And steel, America's most recycled material.
Toyota Truck. Toyota Lee Awesome. That's why Toyota is the number one selling import truck in America. Toyota Lee satisfied owners make Toyota America's number one truck line in customer satisfaction. Toyota Truck. Don't settle for anything less than Toyota dependability. Go ahead, break out of the ordinary. See your Toyota dealer today for Toyota Value, the best deal going.
I'm Tom Warner, and I'm proud to be a member of the Washington area community because we have guys like Gary Clark of the Redskins, who runs the Gary Clark WUSA No Sports Camp.
I'm a football player. I do as good a job as I possibly can, and that really makes me feel good about myself.
I'm a plumber, and I feel good about what I do, too, and to do it right.
The Warner Corporation supports the Gary Clark WUSA No Sports Camp, and you can, too. For information, just call us at 1-800-4-HOT-WATER.
Our film today is about steel, the element of surprise.
Steel cans or tin cans come in all shapes and sizes for use with a variety of products. Steel is recycled into cars, appliances, and more steel cans. But what really makes steel attractive is that it's magnetic and easily pulls out of the solid waste stream to be recycled again and again. Steel, America's most recycled material.
This is insane. They've only got one fax.
They only have one fax line?
Come on. Come on.
Still busy.
You seen Tommy? Tommy busy.
Tommy? Are we busy?
No. Just this one order.
For as little as a dollar a day, we can provide new fax lines for your business. Make the call.
Griffin is going deep and wide open is Gary Clark.
Everybody loves a winner. And right now, as the hottest team in professional football, the ranks of Redskin followers swells each successful week after successful week. Impressively, Washington has rolled to its 11-0 record utilizing whatever weapons have been necessary.
And it's intercepted by Andre Collins. Touchdown, Washington.
Be it a very productive ground game,
Riggs will score.
An air attack that is arguably the league's best.
Touchdown, Washington.
Special teamers that have met the challenges. And a defense that almost has players fighting over each other to see who can get to the ball first.
Jumpy Gathers.
Truly, the kudos could be spread around to many obvious heroes.
There's Ricky Sanders.
As is the case with most success stories, there are other heroes who are less obvious, but whose roles are crucial, like Washington's offensive line, a downright stingy, ornery bunch that virtually refuses to let the opposition even touch Mark Rippon. Their protection has allowed Rippon to throw for over 2,400 yards, 19 touchdowns, and just 8 interceptions. And hey, folks, Rippon is also the league's second-rated quarterback.
Play action. Griffin going for Terry Orr. Touchdown.
I think you got to look at the whole offense. I think the offensive line has been giving Rip time, and when we have given him time, Rip's been able to get rid of the ball quick, and then you got our receivers that are out there and getting open and giving Rip a, you know, a good person to throw the ball to. So it's kind of like the whole offense and the whole scheme of things that we're doing.
Well, I think the number one asset our offensive line has is extreme depth, number one, and coupled along with that, most of the players that are on our active roster are veteran players who have been around for 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 years. And I think when you can keep a group together that long that has played in a lot of games and really knows what it takes to be successful on the offensive line, you start building some type of continuity, and that'll carry over into the games.
And Art Muff inside the five is stopped short of the goal line.
To the offensive line's credit, Mark Rippon has not been sacked the last 27 quarters and has been sacked a grand total of just four times through the first 11 games, a pace that would break the Miami Dolphins' 1988 NFL record of seven.
At the heart of these conversions, protection of the quarterback.
You know, we never want to give up sacks. We expect excellence out of our offensive line, and not only as far as offensive line is concerned, but our quarterback's been doing a great job getting rid of the ball. Running back's been picking up blitz. Our tight ends have been staying in and blocking well. You know, it's a combination. That's where, you know, that's where the word team comes into play. It is a team aspect of pass protection.
Touchdown, Washington.
Just as importantly, Washington's ground game, ranked third in the NFL, has been helped in large part by an offensive line that opens holes for the running backs as wide as the Grand Canyon.
We give them different looks, and it keeps the defenses guessing a little bit, and we just try and come off the ball and reestablish the line of scrimmage, and anytime you can do that, you know, you give the back places to run and room to run.
Room is something that Rippon has had plenty of, so much so that rival quarterbacks around the league envy his protection. Protection, they tell me, would allow any quarterback to play the game dressed in a tuxedo.
It's a foot race.
Reporting for Countdown to Kickoff, I'm James Brown.
Well, the offensive line has really done a great job, and everybody around football knows how important the offensive line is. We're very happy to have with us today Rennie Simmons, the offensive line coach as well as a tight end coach. 11 years in the National Football League, and with Joe Gibbs, what a great job you all are doing this year. Unbelievable. Is it kind of like a dream to you? Rennie Simmons, let's hear it for him. Okay?
You know, what can we say? It's just been totally unbelievable, and it's, we just hope we can continue to have the success we've been having.
We've been around a long time. Have you ever been on a team that's been 11-0?
No, I can't say I have. Not at this point.
No. Neither have I.
I want to know, you played center at San Diego State.
Right.
What was your weight?
About 245, 250.
245?
Yeah. Right.
What do you weigh now?
About 220, 210.
Now, it says... How far do you go back with Joe Gibbs?
Let's see. I bet about 1959.
59?
And
where are we all then?
High school.
High school?
In high school.
Yeah.
Now tell us something. Joe Gibbs is, everybody knows his reputation. He's one of the nicest, the straightest gentlemen. Did he used to have a little devil in him?
Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
Was he?
Tell us about the devil. We don't know that part.
No, he wants to keep that buried. Buy his book. That'll be a good one.
No, but he used to have some fun, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. Joe's a real intense guy, whatever he does, and he enjoys life, and he's done it all through his whole life. So he's a very intense person.
He's a great football coach, too.
Absolutely. No question about it.
The Washington Redskins this year have been so successful in everything they've tried to do offensively. Seemed in years past, Rennie, that people were trying to defense y'all, play loose zones as the Giants would do, make you throw everything and be patient in front of them. Y'all found the way to get deep on two deep zones now from play action that's unbelievable. It seems that you got people running open down there.
Yeah, I think there's, of course, each team you play has a certain philosophy, and sometimes that represents the head coach. You know, they're going to come into the game and they're going to play the way they used mm-hmm. to playing, and fortunately we've been able to, you know, take advantage of some of that aggressive play, and it's paid off.
Even against zones, which is amazing.
Right.
A lot of people give up when they see the deep zone.
I think the key is, even though some of those games we don't really rush the ball for a total, mm-hmm. a lot of yards, you know, less than 100 yards, the attempts has still been 30, 32, 33 right. attempts, so I think that's the key. As long as you're attempting that rush, they feel they got to stop the run because we are averaging over the 11 games 140 yards a game.
Well, the Dallas Cowboys have now said they're going to sack Mark Rippon today. I mean, they put it on the line. And so if they get up there, like the Atlanta Falcons, they thought they were going to sack Mark Rippon too. They put nine guys up there and they got burned deep. And that's kind of what you guys look for. If they stack it up there, they're going to get Mark Rippon. You're going to throw that ball deep, correct?
Well, I think it's no secret anymore because of the deep balls that we've thrown. So they can make those predictions. I think that really does motivate us. I think our players are highly motivated, regardless of whether they said they were going to sack us or not. When you only have 4 sacks in 11 games, that's an incredible record. And our guys right now, you know, want to keep that record clean. And so they're going to do everything they can to keep it that way.
Let's take a break. When we come back, we'll talk about those Cowboys, how you're going to stop them, and also someone, Troy Aikman. We'll be right back.
I'm Tom Warner, and I'm proud to be a member of the Washington area community because we have guys like Gary Clark of the Redskins, who runs the Gary Clark Why Say No Sports Camp.
I'm a football player. I do as good a job as I possibly can, and that really makes me feel good about myself.
I'm a plumber, and I feel good about what I do, too, and to do it right.
The Warner Corporation supports the Gary Clark Why Say No Sports Camp, and you can, too. For information, just call us at 1-800-4-HOT-WATER.
Toyota trucks. Toyota Lee Awesome. That's why Toyota is the number one selling import truck in America. Toyota Lee satisfied owners make Toyota America's number one truck line in customer satisfaction. Toyota tough. Don't settle for anything less than Toyota dependability. Go ahead, break out of the ordinary. See your Toyota dealer today for Toyota Value, the best deal going.
Our film today is about steel, the element of surprise.
Steel cans or tin cans come in all shapes and sizes for use with a variety of products. Steel is recycled into cars, appliances, and more steel cans. But what really makes steel attractive is that it's magnetic and easily pulls out of the solid waste stream to be recycled again and again. Steel, America's most recycled material.
Hey, Pop, I've been thinking.
Well, that's for first.
No, listen, I think we need another phone number.
Well, get out of here.
Well, I've been watching the Pizza King down the block, and it seems like they've been...
Hey, you want to watch your business, watch this one.
Oh, well, they've got 2 delivery guys. We only need 1.
So?
So, they also got 2 phone lines. 2 phone numbers, 2 delivery guys. All we got is 1 phone number, 1 delivery guy.
So?
So I think there could be a connection in there somewhere.
For as little as a dollar a day, we can provide new phone lines for your business. Make the call.
The Dallas Cowboys have an outstanding passing attack. They have outstanding wide outs in Michael Irvin, Alexander Wright, Alvin Harper, and also their running backs are very good pass receivers. This is a diagram of one of their favorite pass plays. And where they like to go here is to their tight end, Jay Novacek. Now, Novacek may not play today, but they will have Alfredo Roberts in there take his place. And what they will do, and we'll take a look at it, this man will go in motion, and he will go out into the flat. Michael Irvin's here will come across the field, taking this linebacker or defender with him. He can run an option here and go out or in. We will see him go across the field, and with that, we'll look at the tight end. Jay Novacek will come behind and settle down in the middle for a big gain of about 17 yards. They'll run it from right formation. And then you'll see the play reversed, and they'll run it from left formation. Well, take a look at this now and see the success they had against the Redskins in the first game. You see the man going right across the field underneath, and they get the ball to Novacek up the field for about a 17-yard gain. Now you'll see the play again in left formation. Again, Novacek releasing, the receiver coming underneath, leaving a big open void for a big gainer again to Jay Novacek. And the fact that he may not be able to play today, Coach, he's banged up, kind of leaves a void in their passing offense some, doesn't he?
Yes, and the play you're referring to in the first game, what happened, Terry Hogue, right before the game, could not play, and he had practiced all week, and so we had to go a substitute in there, free safety, and a couple of guys that really didn't get all the work. So that particular pattern gave us some fits last time. I think we've ran that play a few times in practice this week, and hopefully, you know, we'll be able to defend that a little bit better.
They do have outstanding young quarterback,
absolutely.
And their running back you really have to be concerned about, and Emmitt Smith. But this offense, it seems to me the problem within their offense has to be pass protection, where Riffin's been sacked 4 times, I think. Aikman's been sacked 28 times. Big difference.
Yeah, I mean, I think 11 of those was in one game against the Eagles. You know, I'm sure they, you know, they've had some injuries there where they've had some replace some people. But when you have a quarterback with the athletic ability that Aikman has and ability to throw the ball, you know, you can have a mismatch of guys in there, and he can hurt you.
Let's take a look at some of their offense, and we talked about Novacek. Look at Michael Irvin's here, number 88. Good receiver, can run with the ball after he catches it. Also, Alvin Harper, number 80. You see how quick Aikman is getting back. You were just talking about that, getting himself set. Here he goes to the running back, Darrell Johnson here. But you see what athletic moves he makes to free himself to get open where he can throw the ball.
Absolutely. He's just a heck of a quarterback. And, of course,
here's your guy right here that you got to get a lot of people around, don't you, Coach?
Emmitt Smith. The interesting thing about this guy, he has great leg balance. And, you know, he runs a lot like Ernest Biner, and I think he might be faster than Biner, but has great leg power. And you really can't, you just can't hit him. You got to wrap him up and you got to take him down. Redskins did not do that well in that first game. He had a 75-yard run against the Redskins on a hot night, and he played well, but the Redskins didn't tackle him very well.
I think that's been characteristic of his whole career, everywhere he's played, starting from high school all the way through. He's been a very difficult guy to bring down, and has to be a lot of it due to the fact that he has a great ability to adjust and balance, and he's got thick legs, strong. He's a very strong runner, and he's a tough guy for us to bring down.
And talking with Eric Williams this week, because Smith only played half the game and had 11 carries for 112 yards in Dallas, he said, whatever made him sick, I hope he eats it again. Their defense, Coach, they're ranked about 26 in the league, but up front, they're pretty tough, aren't they? It's deceiving.
Yes, it is very deceiving when you look at the total stats.
Jack Del Rio there, the middle linebacker.
Right. They made some changes this year in their linebacker core, but their up front people, their down linemen, are very aggressive, very tough guys, and pretty physical. And they give you a lot of different looks up front, which makes it difficult to run against.
Well, you see the job they're doing there against the a good running team in the Giants.
I think they improved. They got Tony Casillas from the Atlanta Falcons. He was a heck of a player, number 75. And number 73, Danny Noonan's always been a good football player for the Cowboys.
No question about it. I think Casillas has kind of been reborn there with the Dallas. Right. He was kind of down and you know, in Atlanta, and I think being in Dallas now has kind of rejuvenated him, and he's playing very well.
We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll look at Sam's big hits from last week's game. We'll be right back.
Our film today is about steel, the element of surprise.
Steel cans or tin cans come in all shapes and sizes for use with a variety of products. Steel is recycled into cars, appliances, and more steel cans. But what really makes steel attractive is that it's magnetic and easily pulls out of the solid waste stream to be recycled again and again. Steel, America's most recycled material.
Toyota Truck. Toyota Lee Awesome. That's why Toyota is the number one selling import truck in America. Toyota Lee satisfied owners make Toyota America's number one truck line in customer satisfaction. Toyota Tough. Don't settle for anything less than Toyota dependability. Go ahead, break out of the ordinary. See your Toyota dealer today for Toyota Value, the best deal going.
I'm Tom Warner, and I'm proud to be a member of the Washington area community because we have guys like Gary Clark of the Redskins, who runs the Gary Clark WUSA Sports Camp.
I'm a football player. I do as good a job as I possibly can, and that really makes me feel good about myself.
I'm a plumber, and I feel good about what I do, too, and to do it right.
The Warner Corporation supports the Gary Clark WUSA Sports Camp, and you can, too. For information, just call us at 1-800-4-HOT-WATER.
This is insane. They've only got one fax.
They only have one fax line?
Come on. Come on.
Still busy.
You seen Tommy? Tommy busy.
Tommy? Are we busy?
No. Just this one order.
For as little as a dollar a day, we can provide new fax lines for your business. Make the call.
See them for Toyota Value, the best deal going. CNP Telephone. We're more than just talk. Warner, we do it right the first time. And steel, America's most recycled material.
Got the motor running. Head out on the highway. Looking for adventure. And whatever comes our way. Yeah, I'm not going to make it happen. Take the world in a loving grace. Find all of your guns.
A great segment.
Coach, something we failed to mention in our last segment was the Dallas Cowboys special team. They blocked three punts and a field goal, I think, in the last nine attempts against them.
We're very concerned about that, naturally, and we've worked hard. Coach Severe's worked real hard this week on our punt protection because of Atlanta had a couple blocked there, and so they're going to be coming after us. We've got to be ready.
Does it get more difficult each week to keep this team playing at that same level because they've played so well for 11 straight games?
Really not. They've taken it upon themselves. I think they set the goal for themselves early in the season, and it started coming to place, and they've got their mind set. Each week, we're working just as hard as we've ever worked, and it's just paying off this year, but there's a certain confidence factor this year that the defense has confidence in the offense has confidence in defense, and likewise with special teams. So I think when you put all that together, it makes for a great season.
Now you can trust Sam and Sonny. Any trick plays today?
We won't tell anybody.
I tell you, we have them in the game plan every week. So if they're there, we're going
to
take advantage of them, and we're not afraid to use them, that's for sure.
Coach, thanks for being with us, and good luck today with you and the Redskins. Thank you. And thank you all for being with us on Countdown.
This car has been praised for holding its value. This one for outperforming the stock market. Over the past year, however, no other luxury car in its class has retained more of its value than the Lexus LS400. Maybe this is what they mean by a new world order. Visit your Washington area Lexus dealer and see how smart owning an LS400 can be.
This year, the center of attention is the Fisher-Price Toy Center, where you'll find all your favorite toys, like the Little People Farm. With just a twist, the farm comes to life. Now just $18.82 on sale at Service Merchandise. Every mother-to-be needs their very own baby. The 14-inch soft-bodied My Own Baby, straight from Cabbage Patch. A unique sensor means baby cries when mother's away. Now only $47.82 on sale at Service Merchandise.
They've been at it for hours.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, what do you think of this 300E?
You're my accountant. What do you think?
Okay. Performance.
That's what I like about it.
Safety features.
It is a Mercedes.
But?
You know.
What's it going to cost to own one of these?
It's all right here in the 5-year cost of ownership forecast. The 300E is rated best value over $35,000 of any luxury car.
Can I see those numbers?
I see why you hired her.
I didn't hire her.
No?
No, I married her.
DHL announces 1,466 flights daily. One flight
every 58 seconds. The fastest service to more countries in the world of any air carrier. One restriction applies. You have to be a package. DHL. Faster to more of the world.
The new Patient Self-Determination Act. What does it mean to you? Monday at 4.